Hello, everybody.
Hi.
This is Jennifer.
Yep.
I'm Eddie.
That's Eddie.
We are recapping
yes.
our 2017 Disney World trip.
Yes, we are.
We're going to start talking about our lowlights.
Irma.
Yeah, took our 10 park days down to 7.
And as we've said in other videos, really, it ultimately only took us down to 8, but we were a little bit trying to be preemptive and decided not to take one day. And
so nothing wrong with being safe.
Just being safe, and I wish I could turn back time.
So besides Irma, do you have any park lowlights?
Park lowlights.
Besides annoying people, because I'm not even going to go off on the annoying
people. I always thought you were going to do that, because I thought that was your low. Oh, I don't think so.
I don't think so either.
No.
I loved everything about Food and Wine.
Mm-hmm.
No complaints ever about Epcot.
No.
I mean, Animal Kingdom, it was a tiring day. It's
hot,
a hot park.
So hot.
But it wasn't really low light. I enjoyed Everest.
Yeah.
Too many times
in a row.
Yeah, we know now that we can't do it too many times in a row. But I wouldn't call it a low light.
No. It was just like a lesson learned.
Yeah.
And I think maybe even not be so greedy and just do it one time.
So,
and then with a fast pass and a later.
Yeah. So if that's our lowlights,
mm-hmm.
I'm guessing we have a lot of highlights.
A lot of highlights, yes.
So if we go...
A lot of highlights.
If we try to work from beginning to end,
mm-hmm.
highlights from our first day, mine would be that we got to see Fantasmic.
We have been trying to do that since 2011, so that is definitely a highlight.
Go ahead. I already named the highlight, so I'm going to make...
Baby Groot singing Hacky? Baby Groot singing Happy Birthday to me on my birthday.
That's pretty cool. And our dinner at the Hollywood Brown Derby was phenomenal.
Oh my gosh, that place. I know I'm going to say it again, beef carpaccio. It was so good. Oh my gosh. Yeah, fantastic dinner, fantastic service.
Also, think about highlights. I loved our picture on the Tower of Terror.
Oh yeah, our little pose that we kind of impromptu decided to do that, didn't we?
Yeah, I think Brett was written on the line.
Yeah. Or maybe even we were like on the ride and we were getting ready to go outside.
Yeah, I feel like there's probably still
some
discussion.
It was like last minute almost. But yeah, it was good. That was a good one.
So now how about your highlights from Animal Kingdom, our second day at the parks?
Oh, Nomad Lounge. We knew it was going to be good. We knew it was going to be fun, and it looked quite cool in all the videos that we've seen on YouTube.
But really good food, good drink, but I think one of my main highlights mm-hmm. was meeting Mr. Poo Poo Face. I think his real name is Eli.
Yes. He's 7.
Good little kid. Had some good interaction with him.
Yes, you did.
You
were really bouncing some jokes off of him.
Not trying to be mean here. But we went and we were meeting people that you knew back at elementary school.
Mm-hmm.
And as a couple, anytime you're going to go meet someone your spouse knows and hasn't seen in a while, you kind of feel like you're going to be the odd man out.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I was. I feel like I was the center of attention.
Oh, right where you want to always be.
Oh, never.
Oh my gosh. That was fun.
Like the jokes were good.
Yes.
Sorry, Eli. I am still with her.
You didn't dump me.
I know you said to dump her and you'll be my wingman, but until you fully understand what a wingman does, I don't know if I'm ready to dump her yet. So figure out what a wingman does. Maybe we'll meet up in Disney World next year sometime. And then maybe we can discuss dumping her again, you be my wingman. That dude from Kentucky.
It was dude from Kentucky, right?
Yeah, I just added that dude
because
you like Brandon Phillips.
Yeah.
That dude.
Yeah, and he had some good embarrassing stories for his parents to embarrass them.
Oh, I love asking kids to tell embarrassing stories about their parents.
So that was fun. I mean, I haven't seen Kevin since like 3rd or 4th grade. And then we got to meet his wife, Jessie.
Oh, they were great.
They were awesome.
Love meeting you guys. Got to hang out again sometime.
Yeah.
Or just find me a job out there in Florida so we can go to Disney World more often together. So think about it. Maybe don't think too hard because that was a weird conversation and maybe they don't want me there. Maybe they don't like the way I dig and pry for embarrassing stories.
Welcome to my life.
So
next day.
Next day was Magic Kingdom.
And there, it's magical. So we said low lights were not going to like hit on like negativity, like with people or things.
Yeah.
That people did.
Because that's too easy.
Never mind.
It happens every day. You got to push past it. Focus on the positive.
But what was some highlights?
Of that Magic Kingdom day?
Yes.
It had to be Skipper's Canteen.
Skipper's Canteen for lunch.
Jared,
our server.
Terrific server.
He
loved
was
the jokes.
So awesome. Yes, and the food was really good.
And I'm sure they get, because the theme of the restaurant is like Jungle Cruise.
Yeah, Explorers.
Which is known
stuff.
For its puns.
Yes.
And I'm sure they get plenty of people while they're going over their bit there with all their jokes and their puns that probably roll their eyes or don't find it hilarious.
Maybe you don't get it, but I would hope that you would get it if you were going to eat there.
I loved it.
Yeah.
Yeah, but even looking around, I feel like I saw some people, maybe they didn't know what was going on.
They didn't know how to respond. Maybe they'll feel a little awkward.
Yeah, they weren't laughing at some of the jokes. Like they had stained glass windows as you walked in. And one of the main jokes you heard everyone use, which, and I'm not opposed to it, but everyone's going like, excuse the mess, I've been trying to clean these windows all week, but they're still stained.
Yes. No, wait, but
that's
hilarious. And I'm glad that you remember one of the jokes, because I'm blonde. Anyways.
You don't remember some of the other jokes? Like they showed one little room that's like a library. It's full of books. They said, we tried to get you a table in there, but it's booked.
That I remember, but I wouldn't remember without you here telling me. I do remember about the wall that had all the fine china on it, and he said, there's the Great Wall of China.
Yeah.
But do you remember how he came to get us? There was more than just us waiting to be seated outside.
That guy,
Jared, that awesome server.
Well, so we got there before they opened.
Yeah, just a little bit.
We walked up, because they had the hostess out there, and we said, we got reservations
at
for
11.
Two, blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. And she said, just hang out and they'll be right with you. Everyone from the restaurant comes out pretty enthusiastically. None as much as Jared. And so if we're like standing over here.
Yeah.
This guy comes out over here.
And he's like.
He's like, welcome everybody. The Skipper's Canteen. Party of two. Jennifer.
I mean, and he like came around. Like we're here. And he came all the way around and was looking at everyone else. And then he comes to us. And he's like, come with me.
Yeah, he made a big scene about grabbing us.
I mean, I felt like, wow, this is kind of special. I don't know. It was really.
He was on top of it. Great guy.
So that was a great memory. We did get to do a Talking Mickey. So I got to wear, I had my Space Mountain ears and I had my Mickey heads shirt with all the Mickeys all over it. And we got to do a pose with Mickey. And that was just a fun day, always.
All right. Highlights of first day of Epcot.
Food and wine.
Just anything in World Showcase. I love World Showcase.
Yes.
This is our first experience with food and wine.
Yes.
I've already been over about how it works, how much I love it, but to know they had 35 different booths. Food and drink, and we probably only hit up half.
Not even half.
The time we're there.
Honestly, not even half.
Not even half. I really need to get back there.
We saw Illuminations, which was a goal of ours. We got seated at the Rose and Crown for dinner that night, 7:45 reservations.
I got to play catch with Sergio.
Oh, that wasn't that day, I don't think.
No, maybe it wasn't, but I'm just saying highlights. It might have been the very next day.
Well, yeah, highlights anyways. Epcot, we had another the next day, so Tuesday, Wednesday, we were there all day. Just the entertainment, just the food, the French Bakery, there's my highlight.
So yeah, we hit Epcot up 2 days in a row. Fantastic. Then we had our kind of chill day where we went to Ohana's.
Yes.
And then to Disney Springs.
Yes.
Highlights for that day, first of all, the breakfast.
Was fun.
Was amazing. The service was a little slow. They were busy.
I've heard that.
But it wasn't enough to ruin it for me.
Like,
I would totally go back.
Yeah.
Great character meet and greets.
Yeah.
You got Lilo and Stitch.
Yeah.
And then you had Mickey and Pluto, kind of like in Hawaiian gear.
Yeah. The little Hawaiian shirts. They were super cute.
It was great.
Yeah. And then we went to
the Coke store, did our little belching video.
Wait, before that though, the Polynesian, that was a highlight for me because that has always been like a place that I've seen from afar that I would just like, I just think it's an amazing looking place. And it's got the Hawaii theme. It's got the island feel to it. So it was beautiful and we had video of that. But anyways, then we went to Disney Springs and we hit up the Coke store and barf.
Only because we mix stuff up.
Yeah, next time we go to the Coke store, we were totally not getting any kind of samplers. We're going to get floats. We're going to sit on the rooftop.
Because they had a really cool store. A lot of cool stuff in there. A lot of cool gear.
A lot.
If I loved my son more, maybe I would have bought him something. Because he's a huge Coke guy.
So then the next day was Magic Kingdom again.
With Magic Hour.
Yeah, in the morning.
We got there early. The place was pretty much empty.
It was
we got
to go. Empty.
We went on that. What's that goofy ride called again?
Barnstormer. Like Barnstormer. I don't know if it's still called Great Goofini. I don't know. It's the Barnstormer that I know.
It's a little kid roller coaster.
Yeah.
But we'd never been on it.
Well, she has.
I haven't been on it. I was like, well, I just want to go on it. I like Goofy.
No one was on
it. We went on it. Short ride, 20 seconds.
Front row. It's like 40, 50 seconds long.
It's real quick.
We were in the front seats.
But the roller coaster comes back to the front, and there's no one in the line, so the lady goes, do you guys want to go again? We're like, all right.
Yeah. So that was fun. I mean, we did Dumbo, we did Teacups, and we've both never done those rides. So the classic kiddie rides.
I spun the teacups more than someone maybe would have liked.
I was not okay with that.
Met the stepsisters.
Oh, yeah.
From Cinderella. Yes. I got to make them laugh.
Oh, my gosh. You made them go like this to them, like you said the magic words. So then after that is when we took time off. All 3 days. And then...
So we only ended up with one more park day, which honestly was my favorite.
It was a great day. So we still had the reservations in the morning at Crystal Palace at Magic Kingdom. So we decided, you know what? We're going to go over there. It's our tradition. We kind of do Crystal Palace for breakfast the last day of our trip. We usually spend the entire day at Magic Kingdom. But since we missed our Epcot day, which was that day before, we decided we're going to go to Crystal Palace. We're going to hit up a few rides at Magic Kingdom.
Our favorites.
Yes, which was two times in a row we did Big Thunder Mountain.
That's my favorite.
We did Haunted Mansion, which has got to be close to my favorite. I just love the details, and I love the little shop there.
And the People Mover.
Which,
that park was also empty that day.
It was so empty. I think that's why when I love Magic Kingdom. Early in the morning, empty.
And it was the only hard part about leaving the Magic Kingdom, honestly. Now, it was starting to fill up a little, but knowing that we had planned to go to Epcot at 11.
Yeah, we decided.
When World Showcase opens and food and wine.
Yeah.
It was kind of hard leaving the Magic Kingdom as empty as it was, and ride lines were short.
I mean, even Seven Dwarfs was like probably not even 30 minutes.
I think it was 20.
Yeah. I mean, we walked around a little bit. We did get a couple pictures. We got pictures kind of on the side of the castle close to Liberty Square. We walked through the castle. We just kind of took in Fantasyland and Tomorrowland. We did see one, stopped over and got a video of Sunny Eclipse. And then we took the monorail over to Epcot, which is our only time we used our hopper pass. But it's good to have.
All in all, despite Irma, great trip.
Yes.
I don't know if I want to ever try 10 park days again.
Just because of the dogs.
Because I did miss my house, my dogs. It's a long time to be away from your dogs, your pets, your loved ones.
Yeah.
But we definitely got something planned.
Yeah.
I don't want to give it away now.
But like 2 weeks in, we're 2 weeks out from our trip, and we're like, oh, I want to go back.
Yeah, we're finally finishing up getting the last of our videos up from our trip.
Dot, 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 to be continued.
This is our wrap-up video.
Yes.
And then we're going to get back to our normal lives. You're going to see our date nights, going out to the stuff in here in Colorado Springs.
Yes.
Stuff with the dogs.
Yes.
Normal life.
Yes.
But also vacation planning for 2018. Not going to get into that. So for that, you're going to have to like, subscribe, comment to our videos, share with friends.
Share our video.
If you've got a friend who hasn't heard of us, God bless them. tell them about us. Have them watch, see what kind of stupid crap I say. Especially after I get a couple beers in me. It's
daily.
Nice to show me a couple of those videos.
Yes.
But anyways, do all those things.
Yes.
For us. If you don't do it, that means you don't actually care about us. Just throwing it out there. But stay tuned for more tall tales.
And short stories.
Thanks, everybody.
Bye.